Welcome back to The Rebellion. My name is Shane Hazel, your host. This is your place for peace, liberty, and free markets. Today, I have two very special little guests with me. My sons, Jackson, to my right, and Henry across from me. Say hello, fellas.
Hi.
Hi.
Welcome to The Rebellion, guys. I know you guys hear me talk about this kind of stuff all the time.
Yep.
You know Banksy very, very well. We had the idea the other day because we're obviously, we're permanent homeschoolers. It's just kind of what we do.
Yes.
And we had the idea that because you guys ask a lot of questions about what's going on in the world right now, that we would sit down and we would do this. Because I think parents out there might be somewhat struggling to try to explain some of the more common questions about maybe what's going on in the world. Probably not in this audience, but maybe there are parents out there who can share this with their friends who aren't, you know, fans of the show yet, or who don't listen to the show or watch it on YouTube.
Yeah?
Well, thank you guys for sitting down. So in preparation for this, what we did was I said, hey, if you guys really, really want to do this, we got a little work to do beforehand, didn't I?
Mm-hmm.
Proper preparation, huh?
Yep.
Yeah. So what we did was we said, write down a few questions and we'll go for maybe about half an hour, see how we do, because, you know, attention spans are short, right?
Yeah.
And homeschool, you know, this is a learning process. You guys are doing something right now that most kids never, ever, ever, ever get to do. You're getting to learn about podcasting right now. And your generation, I'll tell you what, I think you guys are going to be master podcasters probably by the time you're 12. You'll probably be showing me some things here. But, you know, to kind of do, you know, a little bit of podcasting, like, you know how you guys start off with a bicycle, right? You guys start off with, like, training wheels and a glide bike and all that kind of stuff?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is kind of like podcasting with training wheels, right? So we're gonna kick the wheels. We're going to try it out tonight. Do a little bit, you know, a little bit of podcasting. Jackson's actually done one of these shows before.
Yeah.
It was a great show. I think it was the beginning of 2019, I think. So a little over a year ago already, man. Wow. Incredible how time flies. But we have very lively discussions around the dinner table, and you guys ask really fantastic questions. Henry, before you forget your question, I want you to ask your question first. Henry is my 6.5-year-old, almost 7. I can't believe you're almost that old.
I'm the middle kid.
You're the middle kid.
Middle kids get everything.
They get hand-me-down underwear, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
All right, Henry.
He likes his.
Henry, what is your question? Because I know you didn't write it down. I know you remembered it because we talked about it before the show. So speak really loud and really clearly into the mic and tell me and everybody what your question is.
Why do people try to scare people?
In terms of corona, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the question.
Yeah.
Well, let's make this really, really clear, okay? Not everybody is trying to scare people. There are some people who will always take advantage of a situation, right?
Okay.
There are just people who want more and more power. They want to position themselves for more power, more money, and things like that, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Most of those people are in the government,
okay,
and in the media. And those people, a lot of times what they're trying to do is manipulate people. What is manipulate, Jackson? What does that mean?
I don't know.
To try to get them to do something that they normally wouldn't do, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to try to guide them in their actions and their thoughts and ideas and things like that. Okay, that's trying to manipulate people for bad reasons. It's pretty bad. But there are a lot of people out there that are not trying to do that, okay?
Yeah.
Most of the time when we find is these larger organizations like media or the news, quote unquote, I call it propaganda, okay?
Okay.
Because most of that stuff is driven by a state. Now, that's what propaganda is.
What is media?
Media?
Yes.
So let's talk about media for a second too. Media is a medium of exchange in terms of ideas. What you know it is radio is a media,
mm-hmm,
right? News is a media. TV is a media. the internet is a media.
What about like songs or something?
Songs or media. Anything you can hear or see or read really is kind of media, okay. Right? It's one of those mediums where we take ideas and we transfer them from one person to another.
Yeah.
And so right now, we're in a weird place as a country because we got people who are supposed to be responsible journalists who are bringing you guys, who are supposed to bring people stories about things that are actually happening, facts, chasing down, you know, what the truth is. And instead of getting the truth, a lot of times what we get are their personal agenda. What is an agenda? An agenda is what they want. Okay. How do they want to shape and manipulate people's minds? That's when it becomes propaganda. Okay. And propaganda is usually tied to something fairly political in nature. Okay.
Okay.
Political meaning that it has to do with the government. Okay. And where policy is somewhere interjected into our lives. What we hope to do one day is not have government in our lives.
At all.
as minimal as absolutely possible. And I hope you guys are the generation that makes that abundantly clear and can do that through peaceful means, right? Okay. So in terms of trying to scare people, Henry, not everybody's trying to do it. Yeah. I think most people don't appreciate it. I actually think most people even understand that that's what's trying to be done these days. And that's amazing because that wasn't always the case. People didn't always distrust the news people out there. A lot of times, back in when I was a kid and I was your age, there was only about 3 channels. Do you know that?
3 channels?
There was no YouTube. There was barely even cable, for God's sakes. It was most of the time what it came in, you know, it was like tuning in a radio. You had a TV with 3 dials on it, and sometimes they were in color and sometimes they were in black and white. And your dad told you were the remote, get up and change it to channel 1 change it to channel 2 to channel 3.
I've seen that at the, what is it called? The space place. Yeah, where we went and like the, I don't know what it's called. Also had dinosaur skeletons.
Oh, yeah, down at Fernbank.
Yeah, that.
The Fernbank Natural Science Museum.
Yeah, that one we just went to.
That's right. TV used to be a much different thing than it is today.
Yeah, it was space. And I was like, whoa, that's a crazy TV.
Yeah, so that's, people used to actually trust the people. Well, a lot of people used to trust them. So,
yeah.
Does that answer your question, Henry? Yeah. Not everybody's terrible, and there's actually a lot of really great people out there who are just trying to get you real information without a whole lot of bias, or maybe just bias towards liberty and peace and free markets, right? Mm-hmm. Which we've talked about before, for sure.
And why do people freak out about toilet paper?
Why do people freak out about toilet paper? Great question. Here's the deal, is a lot of people are still watching all these news people, right? They're still watching mainstream media. They're still watching the propaganda.
So that's why it's running out.
Well, when they broadcast that the store shelves are empty and everybody's running in and there's super long lines to get toilet paper and all this kind of stuff, it builds this thing called hysteria, okay?
Well, I found in the store today, like a couple days ago, you can only take 2 pieces of meat.
Yeah, that's kind of like, that's the store policy, isn't it? Right.
Mm-hmm.
So here's the deal: with hysteria, you may not know that word. Hysterical. What does hysterical mean?
I don't know. It means it's funny.
It does. That's right. Oh, it does. Hysterical means funny.
Oh.
But here's the thing: is hysterical actually really means kind of without what's the term I'm looking for? Without common sense, almost, right? Where you're so excited that you're not thinking rationally, not thinking clearly, okay? And so if you can't think clearly and you're hysterical, not like ha ha ha, but like, oh, I'm freaking out, man, right?
That's how Hen is.
Yeah. Now, that's what the media has done. They've shown enough people enough video of people going out and buying tons and tons of toilet paper, or they've gone out and they've shown all the bare shelves of no toilet paper. And what does everybody think then? Oh, but if I see toilet paper, I should probably buy some, right? Ooh. And so now people are buying more toilet paper than they actually need over a period of time. Oh. And that manipulates the market. That word, manipulate. Do you see how that came full circle?
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful questions, Henry. I loved them.
They're like,
why?
They're like, oh, I need to freak out about toilet paper.
That's right. And that's exactly what they do. So, Jackson, you're going to move on to your questions.
Yep.
Henry, you got about 11 minutes there, and we're only going to do about 30. Okay. So, if you think of another question, hold it, and I'm going to let Jackson ask a few questions too. Okay.
Why is gas cheaper?
Why is gas cheaper? Gas is cheaper right now because a lot of the gas that comes into this country comes in from other places, okay? Mm-hmm. Other places around the world. How does it get here?
I don't know.
It gets here in these giant cargo ships. Yeah, they're tankers is what they call them. These things hold hundreds of thousands of gallons of raw petroleum. Raw means just crude, right? Just the stuff. Used to be when Daddy was a Marine and I was over in Iraq, you would actually drive around in the desert and it would just be coming up out of the sand next to the road.
That's how I see it sometimes, like out of the stove. Like I see like sand in.
You see sand in the stove?
No, I don't see sand in the stove. What I see is like it messes like with your vision and like I don't know.
Oh, you're talking about the vapors that come off of it? Yeah. So,
is that what it is?
Yeah. So, but no. So, petroleum has vapors, right? Okay.
Yeah.
And it separates. Now, this is what happens. The petroleum comes to the United States, and here we have these things called refineries, right? Where they separate the petroleum into different parts of, or different components, right? So, you have gas vapor that comes off of the petroleum.
Oil
is really heavy. And so what happens is you remember when we did that experiment where oil floats on water?
Yeah.
All right. Different parts of oil will actually float on the other parts of oil. So you have really, really heavy sludgy stuff. And you have things that are cleaner and burn really nicely like kerosene, gasoline somewhere in the middle. And then you have gas at the top. And that stuff is really, really flammable. So anyway, this stuff comes to the United States, and here we have a couple of places that can take that really awful crude and turn it into products that we use, okay? The problem is right now, because mostly nobody, is out and about. They're not traveling, right? Is Daddy flying as much?
No.
I'm not taking any trips, am I?
Nope.
Right? Are we going to the stores as much?
No.
I think
it's just because we're up here, too.
Well, we're up here, but...
And there's germs.
Well, right? Like, there's a lot of people who are really afraid of getting sick right now.
Yeah.
And it's mostly really old people who have...
Coronavirus?
Well, no. It's really old people who have pre-existing conditions like diabetes. If they have cardiopulmonary, which means heart trouble. If they're extremely overweight... Those are the people, if they're old and they have all that going on.
And heart attacks.
Yeah, those are the people, that's heart disease. So those are the people who are at risk, okay? You guys, you kids, really aren't at risk. You know, there's been very, very few kids who have actually gotten it. And a lot of the kids, even this tiny little premature baby over in the UK.
Yeah.
She survived it without medication and is on the mend now. Most kids have no worries whatsoever of ever getting corona, right?
Yeah.
You guys were more susceptible to things like the flu, which you already had, I guess, back in December. You guys were sick. Boy, that was not fun.
Nope.
So anyway, because people aren't traveling, that crude is sitting in those oil tankers on the ships, right? Yeah. And they can't offload it. So here's what happens. There's a market for gasoline.
Okay.
I buy gasoline, mom buys gasoline, grandpa buys gasoline, everybody who has a car buys gasoline, right?
Yep.
Okay, so if they're not using that gasoline and that market what happens is you have this thing called a surplus. It means you got too much gasoline. Okay. Now, if there's too much gasoline and not enough people are buying it, what the market has to do, or the people who are supplying us with gasoline have to do, is they have to make it more appealing. Okay? They have to make it more appealing, like if we have, let's just say, a cookie, right? And I put a little bit of whipped cream on top of it.
And we have
is that more appealing?
And we have like 50 cookies.
No.
No, not 50 cookies.
Just let me explain.
Okay.
Thank you. When they make it more appealing, what they do, instead of being $2.50 for a gallon, now it's only $1.70 for a gallon. So what they've done is they've made it more appealing by lowering the price. It makes it more attractive to the people who are going to consume it, right? So if I've got less money, that's a good thing for me as a consumer, isn't it?
Yep.
This is what they call the law of supply and demand, all right?
Is it a law?
It's a natural law. This is really cool, Jackson. It's a natural law. This naturally exists with people, right? People buy and sell things, and they produce things, don't they? Mm-hmm. Right? And that's what they call an economy, okay? Where goods and services are taken to a market and they're bought and sold and traded and everything else, okay? That's economy. Now, with this, we aren't buying and trading and producing as much gasoline, so those guys who produce gasoline, they need to get rid of some of that stuff. They need to still make some money. And so what they do is they lower the price of it, hoping you will buy more of it. And guess what?
What?
People do, right? When gas is cheap, what do? They go out and they fill up the trucks. Maybe they usually take a little more vacation if they can travel. Not this year. And sometimes they even go out and fill up reserve tanks, right? Like your 5-gallon tanks, things like for the 4-wheeler or something like that. You go out and you fill all that stuff up when gas is cheap.
Yep.
Okay. So does that answer your question, Jackson, about why is gas so cheap right now?
And do you have any other questions that you had?
You got some questions right there, Jackson. Go for it. That was your first question. Do another one.
Why aren't public school kids going to school?
Why aren't public school kids going to school?
Yeah.
Well, right now, people are really, really trying to cut down on the amount of exposure people have to one another.
Is it good?
Well, There's what we call a silver lining, right? Mm-hmm. When I teach you guys to be thankful for things, what I'm trying to teach you to do is see the good in your world no matter what's going on. If it's good or bad, you still try to find the good in it, right?
Yeah.
So let's talk about this. All right.
Isn't that cool?
So these are government schools, right?
Yeah.
And so the government gets to say whether or not they're in, right?
Okay.
Okay, so right now there are kids like us, you know, you guys, I should say. I'm just a 40-year-old kid. We have your grandfather who lives with us, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so because grandpa lives with us, if you guys were going to public school and somebody else had coronavirus, and then you guys got it, but you didn't get sick, but you still came home and passed it to your grandfather, that'd be pretty bad, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Ah. That's starting to see that's why the schools are closed.
So it's good?
It's a precautionary measure, yeah. It's good, bad. Now let's talk about the really good thing about it. Right there in the microphone, Hen.
But does the whole school, like, close, like, all that?
Nobody's there, man.
Not even, like...
There might be a janitor there. A janitor is a guy that comes in, guy or gal that comes in and cleans, okay, disinfects, sprays Lysol on all the dirty boogers kids put under desk.
That's stupid.
It's funny, though, isn't it? Kids do that. You should see some of the things that come out of a public school desk, man. It is gross. Some girl, when I was in public school, they pick their nose, they stick it under, they wipe it under, they stick gum under there all
the
time.
Just like Buddy Elf did it.
Yeah, that's right. Just like Buddy the Elf, only he was taking it and eating it, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was. And then there was this one girl who left an orange in her desk. Oh, it was disgusting.
That sounds bad.
I was in fifth grade. I still remember that. Yeah, it was really, really gross. But anyway, here's the silver lining, right?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of kids are getting to spend more time with their family now.
Yeah.
Family She's and friends good. For homeschooling. Mm-hmm. And that's a really neat thing, right? Because most you guys are homeschooled.
Yes.
You guys love homeschool.
Yeah.
Yeah? You really don't want to go to a government school anyway, right?
Yeah, because kids can pick on you.
Kids can pick on you? Yeah.
They can do it here too, but not much.
Does your brother pick on you, Jackson?
No.
Do you pick on him? Occasionally?
No. When I want to.
Yeah.
Like when I'm being silly.
Yeah, when
like,
you're being... Yeah.
I'm like, R2.
R2 what?
Hey, let's stay on topic here. So the silver lining is, guys, is that some kids are getting to stay home with their parents and their parents are getting to stay home with their kids. Now, that might be frustrating for some parents, right?
Yeah, because there's but there's no germs, so that's
well, that's
thing.
Not true
kind
either.
Of
there are kind, just there's here's the thing is there's just germs. there's less people to be in contact with, so there are less germs, right?
Yep.
Okay, and what we're not doing is we're not spreading them around to people who might actually get really sick and die, right? Mm-hmm. That's a good thing, right? Okay, so here. If that does that make sense? Like there are some good things that are happening out there, even though schools are closed and kids are home with their moms and dads and grandparents and neighbors and people who can help them out, right?
Yeah.
I think that's a really good thing.
And like friends.
That's right. Jackson, you got another question over there? We got about 8 more minutes.
4 questions.
Give me your third question.
We already did all of them.
You did all of them already?
Why is toilet
paper okay.
out? Why is gas cheaper than me? Why aren't public schools kids going to school? That's me. And then why are people trying to scare other people?
Okay.
And
so right now, do you guys feel like you got some answers to some of the questions about what's going on out there?
Why is the world trying to kill people?
Why does the world try to kill people? Listen, Mother Nature
is always trying to kill you.
Is beautiful and amazing,
but
she is, she can be really, really hard to get along with sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay. And like she produces everything from majestic mountains and beautiful little guys like you.
Mushrooms
and dirty little bacteria and viruses that are needed sometimes on this planet.
Why are they needed?
Well, sometimes.
I heard
one
this.
Question at a time, okay?
Okay, I heard this one time. They can also cure other people.
They can help cure, right?
Yes. Here,
here's the other thing. Sometimes places get overrun, okay? They get overrun, and people are notorious for this. Sometimes the world... When things are super, super dirty because there are just too many people in one spot. There's too much bacteria, too much pee, too much poop, too much, I don't know, just pollution in general. What will happen is tiny little terrible viruses and bacteria will pop up. And at that point, those things will get into the local people population and they will kill a lot of those people off. Right? Mm-hmm. To strike a balance again.
Yeah.
And that balance is really important here on Earth, right? When we talk about conservation and treating the Earth right?
Mm-hmm.
That is a really important thing. When humans are too densely populated and they're too stinking dirty, a lot of times the Earth fights back.
And
Mother Nature will kill you in a heartbeat if you don't respect her because that's natural law. Anyway... We're going to conclude right there because I see you guys are getting antsy. You're getting really trying to get us off topic and talk about other things. Henry's about to do donuts in the chair over there. Anyway, guys, I appreciate you guys coming over and wanting to talk about this.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do a lot more of this kind of stuff, I think, through the shutdown. Henry's got his finger up like he needs to say one more thing.
One more short question. In space, why can people not hear people?
That's a vacuum. That is not this subject, but I love you to death. Okay? We got to stay on subject. We are signing off. Banks and I will be back here in a minute. But thank you guys for joining us and helping us maybe help some other people out there talk to their kids. Okay? Mm-hmm. All right. I love you guys.
Peace.
Peace.
Bye.
Thanks, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning into the show. We really, really appreciate it. We hope you found some value in it. And if you have, you'd like to go out there and leave us a review, you can go out on any platform that you listen to and leave us a review there. The Apple ones help drive us to the top so that we can reach more and more people. So if you go out there, leave us a 5-star review. We'll read it right here on the air. If you'd like to send us anything, bring anything to our attention, or cover any subjects, you can go to info@rebellionpod.com. And send us something there. And outside of that, if you really love the show and you want to become a patron of the show, you can go to patreon.com/rebellionpod. It really helps out a lot. We send out stickers and letters about on a quarterly or biannually basis. But at any rate, thank you guys all so much. Really, really hope you guys are doing well out there. And we hope this really helps you maybe answer some questions with your kids. But take care. We love you. We need you. Peace.
Don't hurt people and don't take their stuff.